A magician performing at a birthday party stands inside a circle of 15 kids. He's going to choose a volunteer, and he wants each kid to have the same chance of getting chosen. Fair enough. Now, we have three methods by which he can do it, and let's just think about whether each of these methods are fair, where each kid does have the same chance of getting chosen. And if they're not, if they don't lead to each kid having the same chance of getting chosen, think about why that is the case. So method one, the magician starts with the birthday boy and moves clockwise, passing out 100 pieces of paper numbered 1 through 100. He cycles around the circle until all the pieces are distributed. He then uses a random number generator to pick an integer 1 through 100 and chooses the volunteer with that number. So let's just think about what's happening. So there's 15 kids in a circle. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. I planned that out amazingly well. I didn't think I would be able to fit exactly 15, but it worked out. So 15 kids in a circle, and then he's going to hand out pieces of paper. So he's going to let's give 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. And now this person's going to get pieces of paper 1 and 16. Now this person's going to get 2 and 17. You're going to keep going round and round and round until all 100 pieces of paper are going to get distributed. Now, something to think about is whether every child here is going to get the same number of pieces of paper. And I encourage you to pause this video and think about that. If we just keep cycling around all the way to 100, does each child get the same number of pieces of paper? Well, just think about it. In order to get the same number of pieces of paper, 100 has to be divisible by 15. And we know 100 isn't divisible by 15. 15 goes into 100. 6 times 15 is 90, and you have a remainder of 10. So what's going to happen is all 15 kids are going to get 6 pieces of paper, and then another 10 of the 15 are going to get a 7th piece of paper. So they're not all getting an equal number of pieces of paper. So even though he's randomly picking an integer between 1 and 100, some of the students are going to have a higher chance than the other ones. The 10 that have 7 pieces of paper are going to have a higher chance than the other 5 who only have 6 pieces of paper. And so I would say method one is not fair. Let me write this down. Not fair. Sometimes life isn't fair, but in this case, it's not fair. Where we define fair as the same chance of getting chosen, and that's because they all have different numbers of pieces of paper. All of the students are not equally likely to get picked. Now let's look at method two. The magician starts with the birthday boy and moves counterclockwise, passing up 75 pieces of paper numbered 1 through 75. He cycles around the circle until all the pieces are distributed. He then uses a random number generator to pick an integer between 1 through 75 and chooses the volunteer with that number. So I encourage you to pause this video and think about whether this one, method 2, whether that one is fair. Well, method 2 is the same as method 1, except for instead of using 100 pieces of paper, we're using 75 pieces of paper. And so we have to think about, is 75 divisible by 15? And 75 is. 5 times 15 is 75. So in this situation, each student is going to get 5 pieces of paper. Each gets 5 pieces of paper. So they all have an equally likely chance of getting picked. And then he's using a random number generator to pick them. So they all have an equally likely chance. I would say method two is indeed fair. They all have the same chance of getting chosen. Now let's think about method three. Method three The magician starts with the birthday boy and moves clockwise, passing out 30 pieces of paper numbered 1 through 30. So they're all going to get the same number of pieces of paper. They're all going to get 2 pieces of paper each. 15 children getting 2 pieces of paper each would be 30 pieces of paper. So that looks reasonable so far. He cycles around the circle until all the pieces are distributed. So everyone gets 2 pieces. He gives number 1 to the birthday boy, number 2 to the next kid, and so on. So that all seems reasonable, kind of consistent with method 2, except now instead of 75, it's 30. And obviously, 75 was overkill. He could, even here, this is overkill. He just really needs 15 pieces of paper. And he then counts the number of windows in the room and chooses the volunteer with that number. So the question here is the number of windows in the room, is it random and is it evenly distributed? So maybe you could make a case that depending on what building it's in and someone's house, it's somewhat random on how many windows that house happens to have, the house that's happening to host the birthday party. But it's not going to be evenly distributed. Most I don't know. There's probably
some, if you were to sit and plot all of the houses that had a birthday party, you'd probably see that it's more likely that, that they have 10 windows than 1 window. Or it's more, and definitely more likely that they have 10 windows than 30 windows, or even maybe 15 windows even. And so it's not going to be evenly distributed. This really isn't this is, every house, I guess, has a somewhat different number of windows, and the house that is happening to host the party seems to be somewhat random, but it's not going to be evenly distributed here. And I would say it's not a kind of a really good random number generator because it's not evenly generated. And so I would say method 3 is not fair, not fair. The number of windows is not a really good random number generator. A good random number generator, we would want, say, a number 1 through 75, where any of these have an equally likely chance of getting picked. It's somewhat random, the number of windows that building has, but they're not all equally likely.